Hello everyone, my name is Joe Marie and we're bringing you to Ledo. But first, let me introduce you to our colleagues and co-travelers. So, here they are.
Hi, I'm Harvey Kim Laboniti and I'm one of your tour Ledo travelers.
And I am Emmanuel Francis Isotam and we are
the Ledo travelers.
Are we going to do today? That's a wonderful question, Harvey. Isn't it, John?
Yes, that's a wonderful question. So we're going to do and to show the viewers today about the good things here in Toledo, which is our beloved city.
So basically, that means we are going to travel around some tourist spots to which the Toledo city has to offer.
Wow, that's amazing!
So what we're waiting for? So let's go!
Oh, there you are. So basically, we are now right here at the Toledo City's ICAP, or shall we say the Sebeco Park. So this park over here is one of the tourist spots to which the Toledanos tend to go to. Here we can see some miniature cities to which they have created in order for us to explore Cebu City without even going to travel. And so many people tend to hang out here because this park over here is eco-friendly, which means it's good for hanging out, relaxing, and such more. So if you want to see some other spots to which ICAP has to offer, so let's go.
Here in Toledo. Toledanos are very known to be religious and they are so faithful about our Lord Jesus Christ. So one of the faithful in Toledo decided to build this Divine Mercy Shrine, and Kim Harvey Laboniti will be discussed and will give you the ideas what are the things that you're going to see inside the shrine. So here we are. But wait, where's Kim Harvey Laboniti?
Where is he?
Do you have any idea where's Kim Harvey Laboniti?
So why don't we find him?
Okay,
so
let's go. Find him.
Somehow I can find Harvey Kim. Where could he be? Oh, there he is! Oh, hi co-travelers. Welcome to Divine Mercy Mountain.
With the Toledanos' full devotion to the Divine Mercy, one person decided to build the Divine Mercy Shrine, by which you can see the views that we can see in this video. You said you follow me. As our co-Toledo travelers have observed, people tend to come here to pray, to find inner peace, and to show their full devotion to our Divine Mercy.
The beautiful view of the place, and of course this is a tower, and it's a bell tower, of course, that it was just made by the image of God, and so the people will climb the mountain to feel the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ. And as you can see, there's an image of the Holy Spirit and God the Father, the Creator, the Eternal Father of Jesus and Father of all creation.
Hi guys, we are now at Santa Ana Chapel, or we call it Santa Ana Church. It's also one of the tourist spots in Toledo, where you can find the tradition of the church, and you can see inside in it there's a museum and there's a relic of a saint. But one thing that we need to One thing also that we can find here in Santa Ana Church is the human-sized labyrinth. So, let's go.
So here we are at the Toledo City's labyrinth. So as a part of this vlog, we will be trying to finish this labyrinth by letting our co-Toledo traveler, Harvey Kim, finish the labyrinth. So, let's go.
Yes, I'm ready, Emmanuel. Challenge accepted. So, let's do this.
Thank you.
Oh, how was it?
Tired.
Okay, so but sad to say, we really need to have to go back the same path in order that
they ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine.
Can't exit.
Wait, it's like a
whisper. That's no.
I can't take it anymore. My God.
Okay, that's all right, Harvey.
I'm dead. Mother Mary, help me. I'm dead.
Just kidding. I can do this.
Come okay. Woo. So, are you ready for the next round?
Yes.
Okay, in 3, 2, 1, go.
So we are now inside of the Santa Ana Church. So first, there's so much things that we can see here. An example for that, it is the pulpit. We call it the pulpit because that's where the priests, or the traditional priests, where they can have their sermons or their homily. So that's what we call pulpit. And we have the altar, of course, where priests will celebrate their mass for the holy sacrifice of the mass, and we have a lot of saints in there. So let's proceed to the top part.
Hi guys, so we have already inside the seat is candela bra. Called candela bra, that's Spanish for candle stand. So you can see it on year 1967 before the mass exchange. So right now, maybe it was only displayed to the museum to remember us about the tradition of the church. But it made of brass. Of course, there are a lot of things here, and you can only find that here in Santa Ana. So next, we're going upstairs. So before late 1967, they used to have outside menus, the one they used to have the confession box. So you can see here, there's a kneeler, because they usually kneel when they confess their sin. And the other door, we have a chair here, where the priest will be sitting on it to hear the confession of these sins. So usually we need to confess our sin time to time if committed a sin to avoid hell. So that's the history of inside of Santa Ana. But there's many more upstairs, so let's go.
From end to end, upstairs, which you explained to us more about Santa Ana Chapel.
So, here we go.
This is the choir loop. We can see here that there's a piano set it up. And this is there are chairs for the choirs as well. And we can see here the piano. Yes, of course, because traditionally speaking, or the late 1967, before the grand was changed, they usually used the grand piano. And this, by the way, this grand piano is made of wood. And it was produced on the year 1859 from New York. And it was shipped here to be a history. And you can see here that it's string piano. And there are some keys that they are still functioning, but not all. So that's for the choir loop. So as we can see right now, we can see a lot of vestments, priest vestments. We call it the chasuble. And before 1969, they usually use this chasuble as their vestment, especially entering the mass or celebrating the mass. We have the cope for the priest celebration. So we can see a lot of colors in this. So usually we use the red cope for the Pentecost, and we use usually gold for the feast and ordinary days. And we have more there at the side. As you can see, the green chasuble and the green cope. And you can see the black there. And the pink or the rose, color rose. We have the white. So green will be present. Sometimes they will be using the green vestment in order to celebrate or honor the patron saint, Saint Joseph. And we have the green as well. And we have the white for the ordinary time. And we had the black for the Requiem Mass, which is Mass for the dead. And we have the rose for special celebration. So that's what we can see here up.
Oh, hi, Jo Marie.
Hi, guys. So, right now, we're now at College Booth, and you can see the very top part of the Toledo. So, come on, guys. Get up.
Oh, there you are. So, right now, we're at the topmost part of this. So, what we call Grotto. So, as you can see, cameraman, turn around. So, you can see that the view of Toledo is very clear, so beautiful. We can see the beauty of our copper city with a heart of gold. The very topmost part of this mountain, there is so what we call here in Toledo the Grotto. So, we can see an image of our modern night. So, let's go. So as you can see, guys, there we have an image of our Mother Mary over here, sitting at the topmost part of the Grotto. So many people tend to come here, just like the other churches and chapels that we have visited. They come here to pray because, as you can hear, it's so silent, it's so solemn. It makes you want to pray more. It makes you want to experience a intimate relationship with our Lord and a contact with the Mother Mary.
This will be the last part of our vlog for today.
So if you like this video, please don't forget to hit a like, heart, or even wow. Just don't be angry, because this is our Toledo City. So if you want some suggestions, share this with your friends, so that they can see the beauty of our city of copper with a heart of gold. Am I right, Joe?
Yes, that's right. And if you have any suggestions or comments or requests, just don't forget to drop your comments below. So there's a comment box in
Facebook.
Yes, Facebook, as you can see. So that's
will
be. Yes, that will be. So maybe it's time to end the session today.
Yeah, that's a great vlog.
Yes,
we have explored so many spots in Toledo.
That's what a wonderful experience. We visited some tourist spots. Yes.
New things, new knowledge, new cultures.
Yes, that's right. So,
goodbye for now, and we'll see you in our future vlog.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
And have a great day. Goodbye.